prayer to bless and cleanse your home is a great way to declare God's promises in your life and pray for blessing over your entire home and family. Praying for God's protection, guidance, and blessing is like setting up spiritual boundaries, fences designed to keep out anxiety, fear, and conflict. The spiritual world is just as real as the physical world. We all should be aware of spiritual battles. This does not mean that we have to be fearful or try to fight these battles alone. When dealing with the spiritual world, we have to know that because we have Jesus, we have power in His name to overcome any darkness that may come our way. Cleansing our house and keeping it cleansed is important because evil forces always take up residence anywhere that a door has been opened to them. In Leviticus 14, verse 33-53, God recommended specific ways the Israelite people should cleanse a house when they enter the promised land. We're entering a land that was formerly a pagan land, where idols had been worshipped, demonic offerings and sacrifices were made, and homes were literally and spiritually contaminated. If you are a blood-bought child of Jesus Christ, then demons have no place in you or in your life. However, if you have opened a door to them, they will still oppress you until you get that door closed and get rid of them. Tonight we are going to pray to welcome God's presence into our homes. 2 Chronicles 7 verse 15 through 16 says, "Now my eyes will be open and my ears attentive to the prayers offered in this place. I have chosen and consecrated this temple so that my name may be there forever. My eyes and my heart will always be there." We are going to pray that God keeps our home safe. Numbers 6 verse 24 to 26 says, "The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord makes His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace." We are going to pray for our home to be peaceful. Luke 10 verse 5 says, "Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace be to this house.'" By praying passages of scripture over our home, we are taking the word of God and praying them back to Him, asking Him to fulfill His promises in our lives and our homes. Praying over our home will allow us to pray for the people who live in our home, to pray for your home to be a haven and a refuge for those you love, to pray for your home to be a shining light of love and truth in the darkness, to pray for God to take up residence in your home, and for Him to be central in the life of your family. Pray for protection from evil, for peace, unity, and rest. Pray for provision. Pray for guidance. Pray for peace and unity. And pray for salvation. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all opportunities for ground held by Satan, wicked demons in relationship to our home and property. I bound with chains and fathers of iron all wicked spirit in their schemes and assignments against this home and property. I ask my Lord Jesus Christ to evict them from this home and property with any controlling powers of darkness, and to send them where they may never control or harm any person again. Heavenly Father, in the name and authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all past use of this property for false religions, occult practices, divination, magic, sorcery, witchcraft, spiritualistics, healing, and such. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to remove all curses, all spells, all hexes, any witchcraft spells, any voodoo spells, any satanic spells, any occult evil. Heavenly Father, in the name and authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all expression of anger, bitterness, rebellion, and lack of submission to God's will exercised by persons who live on this property or in this home at the present or who previously live here. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to remove all anger, all bitterness, all rebellion, all stubbornness and spirits of separation seeking to rule in this home. Heavenly Father, in the name and authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all expressions of pride and control exercised by persons who live in this property or in this home at the presence or who previously lived here. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to remove all prideful spirits and all controlling spirits. Heavenly Father, in the name and authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all acts of immorality, impurity, indecency, strife, jealousy, selfishness, drunkenness, drug abuse, envy exercised by people who live on this property or in this home at the present who previously lived here. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to remove all immoral, impure, indecent, jealousy, selfishness, drunkenness, drug abuse, and envious spirits. Heavenly Father, in the name and authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, and by the power of His shed blood, I now renounce all generational claims against this home and property, including ground obtained through worship of false gods, practice of sorcery, fortune-telling, consulting with mediums, Freemasonry, or other secret organizations. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to remove all demonic spirit associated with these wicked acts. Heavenly Father, I ask that You do these things according to John 14:14 in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Heavenly Father, I dedicate this home and property to You. It shall be a house of prayer, a house of praise and worship to You, my Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we invite You into this home today. We love You, Lord, and we invite Your Holy Spirit into this home. You are the Jehovah who provides. You have provided us with this home and land. We consecrate this home and land back to You today, Lord. Let the Holy Spirit enter this house and this land. We will honor You today with cleansing this home. We invite Your Spirit into our hearts, mind, and body. Please fill us with Your presence. Heavenly Father, we thank You for all You have blessed us with. We thank You for Your provision. You are the God who provides. We thank You for our families, for Your blessings upon it. We thank You for our home. We thank You for Your protection and Your safety. We thank You for Your inheritance. We thank You for Your sacrifice of Jesus Christ, who shows us Your grace and mercy. We thank You for Your workmanship and created us to do good works. Lord, we thank You for being the loving God and for being with us here today. Jesus, we thank You for the miracle of the cross and that You crushed the curse of death. We may be clean for the sanctification of this family and this house. Your word says in 1 John 1 verse 9, if we confess our sins, You are faithful and just and will forgive our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Thank You, Lord, for Your grace and mercy. Thank You, Jesus, for Your suffering on the cross, saving a sinner like me. Lord, I consecrate the front door of my house to You. This is Your house, and I bind any evil that may try to enter through this door. No darkness may enter, only Your light. Lord, we pray over this house and everyone in it with the blood of Your Son, Jesus Christ. As we pray, Holy Spirit, reveal to us that this is our house that is in defilement to You. Heavenly Father, I pray over our windows. No evil may enter through them. No darkness may enter, only Your light. We pray that when we entertain, it will always be the gladness unto You, Lord, that whoever enters this house will feel the presence and peace of the Holy Spirit, that our words lift up people and glorify You, Lord. We consecrate this house to You, Lord, for Your ministry and hospitality. Father, Your word says in Ezekiel 36, verse 26, that You will give me a new heart and put a new spirit in me. You will remove from me a heart of stone and give me a heart of flesh. I pray into this house where our family congregates, blessings to all. Protect us, Lord, and cover us with Your feathers. Guard our mouths from what we may speak to one another. Let our tongues only be used to strengthen our family and glorify Your works in it. Bless this house, Lord, where our children come to play. Bless this house, Lord, where mothers and fathers come. Bless the family in this house with good times and memories to cherish. I apply Your armor over the family. I repent against defilement I have brought into the house through media. I repent against movies and shows that blaspheme or deny the Holy Spirit, Lord. Forgive me for these sins. In Jesus' name, I close any open demonic gateways from what was watched, Lord. I repent, I renounce, and take ownership of any defiled music I have brought into this house. I confess my sin of listening to music that does not glorify You, Lord. In Jesus' name, I close any open demonic gateway from the music that was played in this house, Lord. May the hearts of the people in my house always be filled with joy. May they be drunk in Your Holy Spirit to the point of overcoming any spirit of heaviness. I pray the hearts of the family always be cheerful and blessed, never to be crushed. Lord, reveal to me the unseen. Reveal to me anything in our homes that is in defilement. Lord, I pray over the bed for dreams from the Holy Spirit. I bind any spirit of fear that comes to bring nightmares. This house belongs to the Holy Spirit, and all my family that sleeps here are children of God. Your word says in Isaiah 54 verse 17, no weapon forged against our family will prevail, and you will refute any tongue that accuses us. This is the heritage of the servant of the Lord, and this is their vindication from me, declares the Lord. I speak in the authority of Jesus Christ and bind any evil spirit in this house. Leave now and go to where Jesus tells you to go. Lord, I bless my children in this house. Loose the gift of heaven and blessings upon our children, Lord. We thank you for this precious child. We thank you for all the gifts that this child has been blessed with. Lord, I pray for blessings in my marriage, unity and strength. Lord, I pray over our bed, for the husband finds no blame in his wife when he goes to bed. Also, the wife finds no blame of any circumstances in her husband. May the Holy Spirit visit them in their dreams and instruct them in the ways they require. Bless the husband and wife with wisdom in affairs of raising godly children. Bless the parents with godly patience and discernment. Lord, I pray over my bed for dreams from the Holy Spirit. I bind any spirit of fear that comes to bring nightmares. This room belongs to the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless me as I sleep in this room. Break loose the gifts of heaven and bless me immensely in Jesus' name. Lord, I come to you about cursed object and demon infestation in my possession, in my home, and in me. I forgive my ancestors, descendant, and others who have had spiritual influence over me. I ask you to forgive and bless them, especially with salvation. Please forgive me, and I forgive myself for spiritual adultery. I forgive those who have cursed me. Forgive me for cursing others. I break the curses and demonic soul ties, including psychic and Catholic prayers. I will clean out my house and curse object or exorcist. I will anoint my house with oil and drop the evil spirit out the house. Show me cursed object, demon infestation, and spirit that need to be cast out, people. Father, I ask that you wash my spirit, my soul, and body with the blood of the Lamb. I curse every corruptible seed that has been planted in me, and I command it to wither and die. I command every foul spirit, unclean spirit that may have attached itself to me, to loose me tonight, to leave this property, to seek dry ground and never return in Jesus' name. By the blood of Jesus, I bind every evil spirit that is in this room and go where the Lord Jesus Christ sent them. I renounce and reject any inch of this house and property that has been yielded or surrendered unto Satan, and by faith I take it back and surrender it to the Lord Jesus Christ. I claim that this room is covered under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ and no evil spirit can enter it. I dedicate and consecrate this house to the Lord Jesus Christ, and Satan has no hold on it at all. I surrender everything in this house to the Lord Jesus Christ and claim it is under his divine protection, including all electrical wiring and plumbing. I bind every evil spirit that is in this house by the precious blood of the Lamb and command them to flee and go where the Lord Jesus Christ sent them. I claim by faith that everything in this house is covered under the blood of Jesus Christ, from the top of the roof to the bottom of the footing and everything in between, and especially anything that conducts electricity. I claim by faith that this house is surrounded by a hedge of protection, a wall of fire, a wall of faith, and covered under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ on all sides, above and below. I pray that powerful warring angels will come to protect the four corners of this house and property and everyone inside. Thank you for the complete victory we already have in Jesus Christ. I ask that this home be consecrated with your divine presence so that everyone who enters it will be blessed with spiritual blessing from heavenly places. To God be all the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.